See, in this particular problem, we are given that there is some boat which is moving in water and it is crossing a raft. What is the meaning of raft? It is some, say, a piece of timber or a piece of wood. So the boat is crossing the raft, going ahead, then turning back and meeting the raft again. Okay. Now, if you see, this problem can be solved in two approaches. Approach one is observing it from the ground, or say from standing on the bank. And approach two is observing it from the frame of water. Okay, so we have two frames of reference from which we can solve the problem. One is the ground frame and second is the water frame. So first of all, we will see how we can solve the problem from the frame of ground. Okay, so I'm writing the first approach, how I can solve the problem from the ground frame. Now, if you see the basics of kinematics, suppose the water is flowing and say the flow velocity is u, let the flow velocity means what? Velocity of water with respect to ground be what? U. Okay, and say let the velocity of boat with respect to water be what? V. Of course, this is what? The relative velocity. See, in this problem, a sentence is given that the duty of the engine or the boat in the water remains constant. Now, see what it means. When you are talking about the relative velocity, when some object is moving in a fluid, say a boat is moving in water or the plane is moving in air, so the meaning of, if the duty of the object in the fluid remains constant, it means the relative velocity of that object in the fluid will remain constant. Okay, that means the boat is moving with a constant velocity in the frame of water. The boat is moving with a constant velocity in the frame of water. That is the meaning of the sentence, that duty of the engine remains constant. Okay, now same when you see the raft. Okay, say we have a piece of wood or timber, anything, raft, and this is in water. So we know the raft will not have any of its own velocity. It is static with respect to the water. Okay, it is static with respect to the water. It is simply, you know, flowing in water with the flow of water. So if I say what will be the velocity of the raft with respect to the water, it will be zero. So what will be the velocity of the raft with respect to the ground? Same as the velocity of water, that is what? U. So if somebody is observing the raft from the ground, that observer will see the velocity of the raft to be simply as what? U, that is the flow velocity. He will see that the raft is flowing along with the water with the same velocity as that of the water. Okay. Now we know when the boat goes downstream, that is along the flow, then if somebody is seeing from the ground, then what will be the velocity of the boat? So it will be what? V plus U. We will apply the concept of relative motion. So V is the velocity of the boat with respect to water. U is what? The velocity of the water with respect to ground. And since both the direction will be same, it is going downstream. So from the ground, you will see the velocity of boat to be what? V plus U. And if the boat goes where? Upstream. Okay, that is opposite to the flow of water. Water is flowing like this. Okay, and the boat is going like this. So what will be the velocity of the boat? It will be like this along the motion of the boat. What? V minus U. Okay, now it will be V minus U. So these are some of the basics of kinematics which we'll be using in this particular problem. Okay, now say the problem is saying that at some particular instant, say this is the boat and the boat is crossing the raft. Okay, that means at this instant both have the same positions. Now the raft is going like this, the boat is also going like this, and boat is going downstream, so both boat has a speed of v plus u, and raft has a speed of u. So of course you can see the boat will have a greater speed than the raft. So if at a particular instant both the boat and the raft are together, so the boat will be going ahead because its speed is greater than the raft. So the boat will be leading ahead. So we'll see after some time boats will be moving ahead as we are observing from the ground. So we will see both are moving. Say this is point O. After some time, say the raft is like this, and the boat will be like this. Okay, going like this. Now it is being told that after tau is equal to 60 minutes, the boat turned back. Now see, after tau is equal to 60 minutes, the boat is turning back. Now after turning back, the boat will be traveling in the opposite direction. That is where the upstream. And when the boat will be traveling in the opposite direction, the raft will be going still where? In the same direction, on the right side. So both will be meeting once again. Both will be meeting once again, say, after reaching a point A, the boat turns back and meet the raft at a point B. Okay, so they're meeting again. This is the raft, and this is what? Now the boat is going like this upstream, and they're meeting at a point B, and it is given, now they're meeting at a point which is at a distance of 6 kilometers ahead of their original position. Okay, so this is how we can visualize how they will be moving and meeting again. Now we have to find what will be the flow velocity. Okay, now if you see, if I make a simple figure with the combination of all these visualization, I can say, okay, say this is point O, and this is point A, and this is point B. Okay, and say the raft has gone from O to B, traveling a distance of 6 kilometers, and the boat has gone from O to A, and then from A to B. Now while going from O to A, the journey was what? Downstream, so its speed would be V plus U, and this will be what? Upstream, so its speed will be V minus U. Okay, and this time is what? 60 minutes. Okay, now if you see, the velocity of raft is what? U, and this time will be what? This time will be tau plus say the time taken from A to B. Now the time given, the time for turning of the boat was 60 minutes. That is the time from O to A. Now I'm saying let T naught be the time from A to B. T naught is what? The time in which the boat moves from A to B. Okay? Now if you see the basic geometry, so can I say OB is equal to what? OA minus AB. So can I say 6 kilometer is equal to what? OA, that is what? V plus U into T, that is tau, minus what will be AB? V minus U into T naught. Let it be equation number 1. Okay, so this is how we got first equation, the OB is equal to OA minus AB. Now if you see the motion of the raft from O to B, say it is moving with a speed U, and what time it will take to move from O to B? So it will take a time of tau plus T naught, that is the same time which the boat is taking to move from O to A, then A to B. See, the whole journey of the boat is from O to A, then A to B, and the whole time was what? Tau, that is 60 minutes, plus some unknown time T naught. So can I write U, tau plus T naught is what? 6 kilometer. So I'll get what? Tau plus T naught is to be what? 6 divided by U. Let it be equation number 2. Okay. So from the basic geometrical conditions, we got two mathematical equations. One is U, tau plus T naught is 6 kilometer. Another 6 is equal to V plus U tau minus V minus U T naught. Okay. Now if you see, basically There are three unknown quantities. We don't know what is V, we don't know what is U, we don't know what is the value of T naught. Usually, when we are solving the equations in unknown, then we must have the minimum number of independent equations as the number of unknown quantities. So it seems like that we have three unknown quantities. So we must have what? How many equations? Three equations, but here we have two equations. So it seems like how we are going to solve the equation, since there are three unknown quantities, but we have two mathematical equations. But you see, sometimes we get the elimination by the combination of the quantities. Now, if you see, if I write equation number 1, if I open it, I will get what? 6 is equal to V tau plus U tau minus V T naught and minus of minus plus V U T naught. So I can write V is equal to V tau minus T naught plus U tau plus T naught. Now we can put the value from equation number 2. In this particular equation, say equation number 3, so I'm putting equation number 2 in equation number 3, so I'll get 6 is equal to V tau minus T naught plus U into 6 by U, U will get cancelled away, and I'll get what? V tau minus T naught is what? 6 minus 6 will be 0. Now by the basic property of mathematics product rule, we know V is not equal to 0, that is the relative velocity of the boat in water is non-zero. So surely you can say tau minus T naught will be 0. So we'll get what? T naught is equal to tau. And what is the value of tau? 60 minutes, or you can say 1 hour. Okay, so this is the value of T naught. This is how we got the value of T naught. So I can say the value of T naught, that is the time taken by the boat to move from A to B, same as the value of tau, that is how the boat is moving from O to A. Now since we got the value of T naught, if you're putting the value of T naught, say in equation number 2, you'll get the value of U. So let us put the value of T naught in equation number 2. So I'll get T naught, I'm taking 1 hour, not in minutes, because you will come in kilometer per hour, 6 has been taken in kilometer. So tau was what? 1 hour plus 1 hour is 6 by U. So U will come to be 6 by 2, that is what? 3 kilometer per hour. And that is the answer. Okay? That is the flow velocity, 3 kilometer per hour. Now you see, at the beginning of the lecture I told you, okay, we can solve this problem by two frames, two approaches. First is from the frame of the ground, and second is from the frame of water. This is how we solved it from the frame of the ground. Now let's see how we can solve it from the frame of water. See, if you come to the frame of water, then the raft will be static, right? Because the raft is static with respect to the water. So now I'm applying the second approach, that is the water frame. Okay, so if somebody is observing from the frame of water, so say the raft will be static. Why? As I told you, raft was moving along with the flow. The raft was moving along with the water. So if somebody was observing from the bank, that person must have seen the raft moving with the same velocity as that of the water. But if somebody is observing from the frame of water, he will see the raft to be what? Static. Now the boat will be moving, and now he will see, this observer will see the boat to be moving with a velocity what? V. That is a constant velocity, right? And we have taken the velocity of the boat with respect to water as what? V. And it has been given that the duty of the engine is constant. That means I already told you the relative velocity of the boat with respect to water will be constant. That means the boat is moving with a constant velocity in the frame of the water. Okay. Now it has been told that the boat has gone for a time 60 minutes what? Downstream. Okay, now say if somebody is observing from the frame of the raft or the frame of the water, both are the same frame, so that person will see that the boat is moving away with a constant velocity, say V, and has taken how much time? 60 minutes to travel a certain distance via downstream, say a distance L. Now after 60 minutes, the boat turns back and comes back and meeting the raft again. Now since you are observing from the frame of water, you will simply see the boat is moving. You won't see that raft is moving. And can I say, in the backward journey also, you will see the velocity of the boat is what? Again what? V. So you'll see the boat is moving with the same speed, whether in the downstream or in the upstream. Why? Because now you are observing from the frame of water. And since you are observing from the frame of water, you will simply consider what? The relative velocity of the boat. You need not to take into account the flow velocity. And it is given the engine has a constant duty in the water. So while going this side, you will see speed V. While coming this side, you will see speed V. And since it is traveling the same distance, so the time taken will be the same. So suppose this time is T prime or T naught, whatever you want to say, it will also be what? 60 minutes, because same distance is traveled with same speeds. Okay, so the total time to and fro time of the boat is what? The total time is 2 of T naught, that is 120 minutes, that is how much? Say 2 hours, right? Okay, now in this much time, if we analyze the motion of the raft from the frame of ground, so it has been given, in this much time the raft has moved how much? 6 kilometers, because it has been told. Now we are observing from the ground frame. Don't get confused. We told right now the raft was not moving. How now the raft is moving? No, the raft was not moving till we were in the frame of the water. Now we are seeing this particular point from the ground frame. It has been given that the raft has moved 6 kilometers when the boat is meeting again. Okay, so from the ground frame, the raft was moving with a speed what? U, same as the flow velocity. And the time taken is 2 hours, because time is frame independent. So you can write 6 kilometer is what? 2 into U. So U will become to be what? 3 kilometer per hour. That is the same answer as we have done the problem from the ground frame. Okay.